Well, we're all done from Moscow. Now it's time to look over all the paperwork that we have collected here and find out our group of life, find out our group of death, and find out our group of mediocrity, whatever it may be. Kate Abdo, Rob Stone, Alexi Lalas, Landon Donovan, Mariano Trujillo here with you. Let's start firing things up. And we have a lot of friends from our good neighbors in England who are part of the production staff. And Alexi went right to Group G, where England is sitting there in the G4 spot, the number 12 ranking overall. And they're in an interesting group. But let's take in all the groups first, Kate, and we'll have you start with Group A. And Russia might have been gifted a pretty good group here.
Exactly. The hosts, I don't think they can have all too much to complain about with that one. Russia, Saudi Arabia, Egypt, and Uruguay. Looks all right to me.
Russia, Saudi Arabia, the two lowest ranked teams in the field. So Group B, top heavy with Portugal, Spain, and then there's Morocco and Iran.
Group C, France, of course, expected to achieve big things. Talented generation at this point. They're up against Australia, Peru, Denmark.
Three in the top 20 in that group. Over to Group D, some interesting storylines. Third straight World Cup, Argentina, Nigeria paired together. Remember, Croatia, Iceland paired together in their World Cup qualifying group.
Group E, very first team to qualify. Brazil up against Switzerland, Costa Rica, and Serbia.
The defending champs in a very deep Group F, which includes Mexico, Sweden, South Korea. Zlatan, what do you think about Group F?
Group G, my beloved England, looking all right here. Look at this. Belgium, Panama, Tunisia, and that is absolutely doable.
You look happy.
Friend.
You look happy, Kate.
You can't control your
Last group,
league.
Group H, Poland. Again, the top seed in Group H. Colombia, the second seed, they're in at H3, then Senegal and Japan. Not exactly an overwhelming group in Group H, but let's go back one group, Lex, to Group G. Belgium, the headliner, and then everybody kind of waiting to see where England would fall, and that's where they go.
Yeah. So England, I guess the prevailing wisdom would be after this, if you don't get through, you might as well just pack it up and
just give up soccer
just
as a sport.
Completely stop playing soccer, which means they're definitely finishing last in this group. Look, this is an interesting group, especially when it comes to what Belgium is, what England may be, and there's a whole lot of optimism, as there often is before the tournament. We'll see how it finishes
and
it off.
And rightly so this time around, Alexi, wouldn't you agree?
Well, there's always optimism. Whether it's right remains to be seen when it comes to the senior level.
There's but not look, optimism, against, there's pessimism.
Against Tunisia in that first game, that's 3 points right off the bat that you got to put in the bank, right? They couldn't possibly, Kate, England couldn't possibly lose to Tunisia in the first game of the World Cup.
There is always the possibility that England could lose to anyone, but I absolutely agree that
but
is a doable
it's an interesting group. It's an interesting group, and I know we'll go through the groups of death and stuff. It depends what your definition of group of death is. I mean, so I look at Group H, for example, and it's very difficult for me to pick who would come out of that because it's so evenly matched. So in that sense, that for me is a group of death.
Again, right? Remember, they were trying to avoid that proverbial group of death with the way they had the seedings laid out in the pots this year. But we also came up with a topic in the pregame show that if the way it's set up, there's this potential for this group of life where you're going to have one team that's the heavyweight and three contenders in there saying, hey, we all got a shot to get to the next round. That group is clearly A.
Well, it's not just one team that's the clear. There's no clear favorite. And
you don't think Uruguay is a clear favorite?
I don't know. I mean, do you think Egypt is scared to play Uruguay or Russia?
I think it was a clear favorite over Egypt, Saudi Arabia, and Russia.
You never know. I'm trying to figure out how on earth did Russia get such an easy group. I just don't know how this could happen. But I think Uruguay probably ends up topping the group. After that, like you said, it's a crapshoot. Russia are ecstatic right now to see this.
The two lowest ranked teams coming into the draw, get paired together in the group. And remember, Russia with that home field advantage. And they open up with Saudi Arabia in Moscow, opening game of the entire tournament. And it's one of those themes that always develops, Kate, through a World Cup, is you have to start strong. You get those 3 points and you get all the momentum, you get the fan base, you get the media base behind you. But if you start off with a loss, things can go south quickly. And here is Russia with the next lowest ranked team in the tournament that they get to open up with. I think it's an absolute gift for Russia.
In a World Cup, I think back to all the World Cups, and if you start well, you have a chance to get through. If you don't, in 2002 we started well. In 2010, we started well. We got through. In 06, we got smashed by Czech Republic. Tournament was over. So and that's, they have to win this.
That's why these opening games are so important. So everybody's looking at that opening game. France is saying, all right, no problem. We get 3 points against Australia. The one that stands out to me is in Group B, this Portugal-Spain off the bat. That's going to be very, very interesting. And I got to say it, going back to that Group G that I talked about, Panama in that second position, it would have been potentially the United States possibly playing Belgium. Against Belgium in that first group had they gone through. It's interesting to see, and we will do that probably constantly for the next 6 months, saying what if.
Don't remind us.
Don't think about the past. What about Group E? I mean, Brazil, I think they got a comfortable group, Switzerland, Costa Rica, and Serbia. I think Brazil under Chichi had a great spell during the qualifiers.
Spelled with two T's, but we're going to pronounce it Chichi.
They have the talent, they have the confidence, they have Neymar, which he's taking the whole responsibility. I think Brazil is comfortable in that Group E, which doesn't make me happy, because that means that if Mexico advance the next...
And finish second.
Yeah, if they finish second and advance to the next round, they will be facing Brazil in Group E.
But I don't think this is straightforward for Brazil. I mean, Switzerland are a very good team. Costa Rica are a team last World Cup.
But I don't like Costa Rica. I think Costa Rica is getting old, you know? They don't have new players.
But they're clever, they're tactically good. Yeah.
They're comfortable in this.
Well, they've been there. They had a fantastic World Cup last time, so they're not worried. And Serbia are the best pot four team. Yep.
And remember, Costa Rica, nobody gave them love in the group of death 4 years ago. And what did they do?
They won it.
They won the group.
Right. Yeah, so true. I don't think it's so straightforward for Brazil.